Hello guys, welcome to this class. And in this class, we'll be setting up our server file or our server, our Express server, and also we'll be setting up MongoDB for this project. Alright, so in the last class, we set up our package.json. I would like to push that update to GitHub. So at the end of every class, we'll be pushing to GitHub, and if I forget to push to GitHub at the end of a class, I'll push it in the next video. So I would like to show you one thing that one way I do it with VS Code. I'll be doing that with this particular class. So in subsequent classes, we'll be using the command line to push. It's always better if you are starting out coding to master command line commands and master command line interfaces instead of GUIs. But Microsoft has done a very, very fantastic job integrating Git into their text editor. So how do we push to Git with VS Code? Over here, you have your Git source control here. If you've set up Git on your project, you should have this indicator here. So click on it. So I have two changes that needs to be pushed. One thing I can do is to either click on stage changes for each of them, or I click stage all changes. So what I've just done now is to add the projects. This is what we would usually do with Git add in a command line. So the next thing to do is to commit the changes. So I can commit with added package added package your JSON file. I think that's okay. So click here to commit. Now you can see that we no longer have any notification here. So how do we push with VS Code? Can push here. Push the dev branch. I'm guessing that didn't work, but to be sure, I can do that with the command git push. You can do it with this method, but one thing I usually like doing is to check for my remotes. So my remote is origin. So I can push to my remotes. Git remotes, git push origin, then the branch. Okay, so this is why I usually like to set up my SSH. If you don't set that up, you might be getting this GitHub login prompt all the time. So I'm going to pause the video now and put in my GitHub login. Okay, so right now I have pushed to GitHub. You can see here the changes have been pushed. To confirm, I will just come here to GitHub, refresh this page. You can see dev had recent pushes less than a minute ago. I'm currently in my main branch, so let me switch to dev branch. Look at my changes here. So like I said, we'll be working closely with the dev branch, and when we are done with any major push, we would merge our branches, so we would push updates to the main. Yes, so that's it for that. Let's now set up our server. So under here, okay, there's one thing I forgot to do, and that is here. Let me just change this to server.json or .js. Really doesn't matter, but I always like to do that because my server.js is my main file. So I create a new file called it server.js. Let me close this for now. Alright, so what we'll be doing in this file is I'll be listing out the things that we'll be doing inside server.js. Number one is that we'll be creating an Express server. So you would know how to create an Express server here. Also, we'll be connecting to MongoDB in this file. Then we'll initialize Express, and then we'll initialize Express middleware. Also, we'll just create a simple GET request here. Then after that, we'll inject our routes. So I'll be explaining what routes are later on in the course. And then lastly, we'll listen to our connection. All right, so all that I say right now, let me just list them out for you. So if you are following me, you have something, or you would know what I'm doing. So like I said number one, I'll be creating Express server. Number two, we'll connect to MongoDB. Number three, we would initialize Express. Number four, initialize Express middleware. Create a simple GET request. Routes. This is optional. You can choose not to do it, but I always like to do it. Then we'll inject our routes. Number seven, we'll listen to our app connection. Alright, so let's get started with what we've listed here. So you've probably learned how to do this in previous classes. So how do we bring in the Express package? Do that with const Express equals require Express. The next thing to do is to bring in a function which I would later be creating, but for now let's just write that function down. Const connect db. This is a function that doesn't exist yet. I'll be creating that, so we'll be requiring that from a folder called database or DB. We don't have that yet. I'll create that later. Okay, so we'll connect to the DB here. Like I said, don't worry about that. We'll do that later on. So let's initialize express const app equals express initialize the middleware also. Do that with app.use express.json. So all these are just basic set express setup. You can probably see them in the express docs. If you are confused, check up the express docs and read through it for a basic express setup. Alright, so next thing to do is to let's create a basic express route. So we'll do that with the app. So app dot get, you've learned about this before. So app dot get takes in the URL first. So the URL is just the local hosts, our local host, our home URL, which is slash, and then it takes in a callback function which takes in two arguments, which is the request. We've learned about this before, and the response. And then we are going to be returning response.json. And our JSON object is just going to be a message which says welcome to tutoring. So really simple. All right, so the next thing to do is to create our ports. And I usually like to create my ports in the .env file. So the .env file is where you'd like to keep sensitive information about your app, which you don't want to expose. So anybody that looks through your repo is going to see all this code. But if you store in sensitive codes or sensitive part of this application in your .env, Git hides .env, so when you are pushing your code, it doesn't push .env. Just the same way you have the node modules, Git doesn't push node modules if you include it in your Git ignore. So you can see in our Git ignore, look at all these files that have been included here with the GitHub node templates that we did earlier in the last class. So you have node modules here. Look at .env here. So Git is not going to push .env. So let's quickly create a .env file. All right, so in my .env, you're saying .env. So in my .env, I'm just going to put in ports, and our port is just going to be 9005. You can decide to make your own port difference, maybe 4000 if you like. Let it at least start from 4000. Alright, we save this. This is just going to be it for now. We'll come back to this later. So back to our server.js. Let's create a port. But before we can create a port, remember we created the ports, we stated the port variable in the .env. To use that, we'll need to require the .env package. Require.env.config. Yeah, so this just allows us to, you know, use the environmental variables in the .env. So allows So now that that is done, I would like to do something known as this the constructing. So I don't know if you've been learning vanilla JavaScript. Something that is usually done is that you deconstruct from JavaScript objects. So how do we do that? We do that with const. Now I want to bring out this variable. I want to bring out this variable ports from our .env. So ports equals process.env. So this is how we do it. If we're not going to deconstruct, we would have done something like this: process.env.ports. Yeah, so we're deconstructing this. That means we're bringing out this ports variable from this object. Alright, so let's use the ports variable now. So we're going to say const ports equals process.env.ports or port. So this ports is from here, right? Then we listen. So app.listen ports and a callback where we're just going to console log a message. So we can say app running on ports. Those are ports. Ports. Whatever port it is. Alright, so that's going to be it for the server. Next, we're going to create our database connection. So to do that, I'm just going to create a new file. Called DB. So notice how I'm separating my concerns. Usually some people might choose to do their database connection in their server.js, which is fine if you'd like to, but you can also separate your concerns by, you know, creating other files or other folders for your connection or for any other thing you would like to do. So inside my DB file, I'm going to create DB folder, I'm going to create a file called index Node.js. Okay, so in our index.js, we're going to be connecting to the database. So I'm just going to list some of the things that I would be doing in this file. So if you are following me, you would have a clearer understanding. So my comments. And again, I usually do this because it's really good for documentation, number one, and number two. If you are in a team, you are not the only one coding, and you're not coding for yourself, you're coding with other people. So they might not necessarily understand what you are doing in a particular module. But when you have things like this, like comments, it's very clear to your teammates what you are trying to do. So it's a very, very good way of coding with teams. And it's something that I would like you guys watching this video to pick up. So comment your code commenting is really, really important and cannot be overemphasized. I would rather like to read a code that is commented instead of a code that is not commented at all. So yeah, number one, we're going to be creating a connection function for MongoDB. We'll be using Mongoose for that. Number two, we'll start a local MongoDB server connection. Number three, start local. Okay, I think that will be all for now. Okay, let's implement this. So const mongoose. So we're going to require mongoose. Like I said, if you've watched the previous database videos where you use the Mongo clients, it's a little bit similar. Mongoose is built on MongoDB clients, but with Mongoose, you can easily create your database schemas, which you use to map to your database. We're also going to be requiring the .env file. So let's create a connection. Connection function. So how do we do that? We do that with Mongoose, like I said. So we can do it like this. Connect DB. So connect DB, this is the file or the function that I told you guys that I was going to create later on. So connect DB. So this is going to be a function. So I'm using arrow functions. I've explained arrow functions in previous classes. You can decide to go the old method with the function keyword. So say mongoose dot connect, which is going to take in a connection string which we've not created yet. So let's go back to our .env file. Like I said, it's very good to create sensitive variables in your .env files. It's going to hide it away from the main code. So in our .env file, we'll be creating a variable called Mongo URI. So this will be our connection string. So for our Mongo URI, I'll be using the Mongo local DB connection string. Another option for you is if you're having problem with installing MongoDB to your local machine, another option for you is the MongoDB Cloud, MongoDB Atlas Cloud. So I decided not to use Atlas because I've exhausted my my Atlas free tier. So if I would want to use Atlas again, I would have to create a new account, which I'm not really up for right now, maybe in another lecture. But it's really, really easy to set up. All you just need to do is to sign up, set up your database. So set up your database and connect and then get the connection string. But for now, I will be using the local DB MongoDB Compass Atlas. So this is what we're going to be using for this course. If you don't have that, just quickly download that. MongoDB Compass Community, sorry, that's what it's called. Compass Community. So you download that here. Once you download that, install that. So I'll be showing you how to connect to that database. What this does is that it gives you a graphical display of your database. So in your previous classes, you've been learning to connect to database with the shell command, the MongoDB shell. I'm not too familiar with that, so I don't really use that. I use this instead. I prefer to see a visual representation of my database rather than command representation or command line representation. But whichever one you choose to use is fine. Just make sure that you are not stuck, and if you are stuck, do some research or ask for help. So in here, I'm just going to put in my MongoDB local string, MongoDB /localhosts/, and then we'll be calling this tutoring app database. Let's save this. We'll bring it in here. So we're going to deconstruct from our process.env right now. So const, we're bringing in Mongo URI. Is setting that's what we named it, Mongo URI. So we're bringing it in from process.env, right? All right, so this is going to take in our connection string. So Mongo URI. Now the next thing is to set up some setting options, MongoDB options, and if we don't set this in, we'll be getting some errors. So they are very important to set up. So the first one is use new parser, new URL parser. We're going to set that to true. Next one is use create index. Set that to true. Use unified topology. Set that to true. And use find and modify. Set that to false. Right, so we've set our options now. that's about that one. Now Mongoose returns a promise. So how do we handle promises? We've learned that in previous classes. We handle them with then, which takes in a callback. So here we can decide to return a console log. So here we'll just say MongoDB connected. Later on in the lecture, I would like to seed some data. I'll be doing that here, but for now we'll leave that. So the next thing to do is to catch any error. So we'll catch error. So catch error and return a console.error. So I'm just going to be logging the error.message if there's any error, and we're going to be exiting the connection. Failure. So process.exits one. All right, so this is one way to, you know, create a connection in MongoDB. I would like to show you another way, which is my preferred way, which is the async function. So async function, async mongoose connection. So you know mongoose returns promises, so it's always good to use async with your promises. So async awaits. So we do that like this, const connect db. So it's just the same, only that this is an async, it's going to be an async function. So function. And how do you make your functions async? Put async here. Next, we're going to try catch. And in here, we're going to await mongoose. So this is going to take in your Mongo URI and then your options, which I'm just going to copy from here. So whichever one you choose to do, this is my preferred way of doing creating my connection with Mongoose. Just arrange this. Okay, so the proper indentation of your code is always necessary also. What next did we do here? Our connection, console log a message to show that our connection or our database is connected. So we can do that under here. So console.log MongoDB connected. Like I said, I would like to see some data later on in the course. I'll be doing that here, but for now let's leave that. Next we're going to catch the error. console.error.message. And exit with failure. process.env or .exit, sorry. One. Now, what we're going to do now is to export this function. So we're going to be exporting this function so our server can use it. So we can use it in our server. How do we do that? We do that with module.exports equals connect db. Save the file. So now we can bring this in here. Oh, we've brought it in already. Yeah, we've brought it in here. So you can see now by holding down my control key and hovering around this connect db string here or function, you can see that we have a definition of what connect db is. So that should be all for this. Let's test this out. Let's see whether it works. So I'm going to be opening Postman. I will wait for that. Let's start up our server. I'll do a clear here. Okay, so Postman has started right now. So before we test the app, the app is not going to connect because we've not started our database server. So how do we start a local database server? We do that with the command line. So open command line as an administrator, run as administrator. So from here, we want to navigate to the C drive. So CD. So I'm in my C drive right now. So now, chances are you are doing this for the first time and you've not created a data file. So if you've not created a data file, you have to create a data file. And how do you do that? You do that by saying md. So the md for make directory data data, then a db. I have already done this already, and I'm going to be showing you where the file is right now. So it's in my C drive. Data, look at it here. My DB. So this is what we're going to be making. So if you've not done that, you can make that with your command line. So let me clean this off because I've done that already. So the next thing to do is to, run MongoDB. So okay, so I'm sorry, I don't have that off the top of my head. I had to go and quickly look that up. But you can connect to the MongoDB. So I'm going to navigate to the MongoDB file here. So MongoDB. So server 4.2. Bin. So we're going to connect to this MongoDB with this application, but we're going to be running this application in the command line. So how do we do that? We copy this these parts, copy these parts, and in our command line we paste that and slash mongo dot exe. Yeah, that should be it. So mongo.exe, and I'm going to put a db path. So our db path is going to be that file that we created, so which is c slash data slash db. So this should work. Close all this down. Okay, didn't recognize what db path was. Why? Let's try again. Should work. Okay, let me check real quick. I'll be back. Okay, I think I've seen my error. Instead of mongod, I had mongo. So it's mongod.exe, then db paths, which is my C drive slash data slash db. Hopefully this works without any issues. Okay, yeah, so it works now. Our server is starting up. You can see here, waiting for connection on port 27017, which is the local host ports for MongoDB. So yeah, so it's been created now. So let's just start up the Compass. So Mongo. MongoDB. So while that is starting up, we can just start our server with so I failed to show you guys this, so let me just quickly do that right now. In our package.json, we need some scripts, and we're going to need stats. Node server.js. So when we use npm stats, it's going to run this command. Or we can choose to use nodemon. So we can say server nodemon server. JS. Let's save this. This is starting up right now, and we can see nodemon or npm server. If we did everything correctly, we shouldn't have any errors, hopefully. Okay, let me not close this now because this is a very important work I'm doing right now. using this. Alright, so we have error, it didn't work. Save this file. Save our file, our server file. Index. Let's try again. And so okay, I'll be pausing the recording now because of time. Let me quickly go through what is going on here. Okay, so I got the command wrong. The command was npm run server. So npm run server, that's what you would type in. And yeah, npm run server. And it's trying to connect right now. If everything goes right, it should connect to the database also. Alright, so you can see over here, app connected supports 9005, and then our MongoDB connected. So MongoDB is connected right now. Let's test out our get route. So we created a get route initially. So let's test out this route. So test our postman. So our local host route is, or port is 9005. So we just want to test out the home routes. So you can see here we have the message welcome to tutoring app. You can also test that out on the browser if you like. So localhost 9005. So welcome to tutoring app. So it's a JSON object, so it's formatted in JSON format. And if we check our database, if all things work out fine, we can just click connect. We should probably see our database. Okay, so it's not there yet, but it's fine. That's because we've not seeded some data. In the next class would be, you know, starting out with authentication and authorization, and to do that we'll have to create some modules and some data also. So we'll be seeding data with that, and hopefully if done well we should get a database here.